All right, well, welcome back to our channel. Today, we're gonna talk about hacks about living in San Diego.
No.
And it's gonna start
about useful hacks when living in San Diego.
And we're gonna start right now.
No, that sounded mean. I didn't think you were gonna keep that in. I'm gonna tell you the first useful hack. For me, is one of my favorites because it gets you a great discount on some.
And you talk about it all the time.
I talk about it all the time. So if you like to visit the museums here in San Diego, you go to Balboa Park. There's a lot of great museums that you can take your kids to or take yourself to. But they can get kind of expensive. So I found this little San Diego hack, and it works for the Natural History Museum and the Fleet Science Center, and that is to sign up for a membership to a reciprocal museum, a less expensive membership. I have a membership to the Delaware Natural History Museum, and a family membership there costs $60 for the entire year, and you get a reciprocal membership to specific museums all throughout the United States. They just have to be part of the NARM program, which is the North American Reciprocal Museum program. Right. And you can find that out on any website.
Wherever you're moving from, whatever state you're having, they probably have a reciprocal membership.
And possibly less expensive than buying like the Balboa Park Explorer Pass, which I think
which is expensive, right?
$300 or so. So for $60 a year, you can get into a lot of different museums all over the United States, and specifically a couple of the really good ones there at Balboa Park.
Okay, next one on our list is San Diego does have an international airport here, but it's also not the cheapest airport you'll find in the United States.
Not the best flights. The best flights.
They only have one runway in San Diego as well. It's the busiest one runway airport in the country.
I believe it, hands down.
So if you're looking to go on international flights or even flights to Mexico, there's other options out there. LAX Airport, which is about a two-hour drive, depending on traffic. The flights there are just much cheaper. So we were looking at flights to go into London, and the flights out of San Diego were about $800, $900. Out of LAX, it was $330 round trip.
Non-stop.
$330. It's ridiculous.
Deal. Yeah.
So there's a lot of airports in the area that you can go to other than San Diego, and they're just a short drive away, relatively short drive away. Yeah. And the Tijuana Airport, if you're going to one of the beach towns in Mexico, like Cabo or Puerto Vallarta, the tickets to them are usually about half price from the Tijuana Airport rather than San Diego Airport.
And which is easy to get to.
It's easy to get to. It's about a 30-minute drive, 30, 40 minutes, and you can park on the US side and then walk across the bridge into the Tijuana Airport.
Right.
And walk right in. So it's a lot. It's usually about half the price. So it's a really good deal, and it can save you a lot of money. Another thing that I really enjoy talking about again is parking, as you guys probably have known that already. But the airport parking at San Diego Airport is not great. They have a couple like the big lots, like Aladdin or Wally Park. But there's two hotels over there that actually let you do long-term airport parking there, and they're actually cheaper than all the other parking lots around there. So the Sheraton San Diego Hotel Marina is $12 a day with valet parking, and they have shuttles that come every 15 to 20 minutes.
Can't beat
which is a great deal.
That is awesome. And you don't have to be staying at the hotel to use their hotel.
And the other hotel over there is the Four Point Sheraton, which is only $10 a day, but I haven't actually used that one, but it has said the service is not as great. So it's probably worth spending the extra $2 and parking at the Sheraton Hotel and Marina.
Next on the list is another thing that I talk about all the time.
I've never heard
so
you talk
sick
about this.
Of hearing this, but if you don't all buy this, I don't know what you're doing.
Yeah, I mean, I actually found out about it from you. So I lived here for like 5 years before I found out about it, so.
Wow, it's a long time.
It is a long time.
You've been paying for parking. We're talking about the California State Explorer Pass. You have been paying all those parking fees.
Ridiculous. Every 20,
it's
25 bucks every time.
Killing you. So the California State Explorer Pass is about $195, and it allows you to park at almost all of our state beaches and state parks as well. There's a whole list, an entire list online of the parks and beaches that are included, but it's a lot of them. So just take my word for it. It's a lot of them. And if parking drives you nuts, especially when you've got all of the stuff that goes with beach trips, if you've got kids, or even if you don't have kids, you just think you have stuff when you go to the beach. You've got chair and towel and or surfboards if you surf.
The convenience of this pass is...
You get to park in these...
It's priceless,
very, the parking lots are very close at a lot of these state beaches. Smart. You love parking.
I do love parking.
So
parking. And you love donuts.
I love...
I know.
parking donuts.
We should just do a parking donut video.
It's kind of sad that you love parking donuts. Like everybody loves donuts.
That probably makes a little bit more sense than what I like, but.
Another thing that is great offered here in San Diego is an entire month, the month of October, kids go free to the San Diego Zoo, which is like a world-renowned, amazing attraction right here in Balboa Park. And you can take your kids for free for the entire month of October. With one paying adult, full price paying adult ticket, you can take
as many kids as you want.
I think you need to double check that.
I'm sure it said it on there.
35 children.
I will double check it.
Did they let you do that?
Yes, the 35 children, they will let you go.
What?
Probably not. No. That
for one paying adult?
That also seems ridiculous.
That does. But, maybe it's like 10.
But I don't know of any other place that will let you go for an entire month for free to any park.
I know. And October's a beautiful month in San Diego.
Disneyland sure doesn't do that.
Oh, man.
But that's a great deal. I mean, there's not much places that will do something like that.
And
so
again,
and the weather
here wonderful.
In October is really good, so it's a really good time to go visit the zoo.
Yes.
And I think it's good for the safari park as well.
Just didn't know that. That's great.
Yeah,
I like that.
It's a good deal.
I'm gonna go and take all 35 of my kids.
Another thing you can get, another place you can get free days to is all the museums at Balboa Park. So there's usually one day a month for each. Almost all the museums there at Balboa Park, you can go for free. It's usually a Tuesday or Thursday.
Okay.
So it's not like this weekend days, but it's for the summertime, it's great. So if you're trying to find something to do with the kids, just put it on the calendar and say, the Fleet Museum, I think, is a Thursday, and then
Natural History Museum, I think, is a Tuesday. So it's one Tuesday a month.
Yeah.
That's a good one. You just have to check on the website, make sure you
get
the
date. Yeah, I'll try to put links down below so you can see the answer. I know, I'm a really nice guy.
So nice.
Can I say?
We're just finding all the free and interesting hacks.
I mean, this is stuff I would want to know. That's why I put it out there. Because if I would have just moved here, I wouldn't want to know this information.
This would be great.
Pass it along.
This would be so great. So the next thing is the SeaWorld preschool pass.
Right.
Which is for children 5
Another
and under.
Another great deal.
I know. Children 5 and under who live in San Diego County or Orange County can sign up. They have 10,000 free memberships for children 5 and under, which is why it's the preschool pass only. And they open a registration on their website on
December of the previous year.
So right. December 2019, they opened for 2020.
And we're filming this in February and it's already sold out.
So you gotta get it when it starts. There is a finite amount.
10,000 is a lot, but they do go quick.
You just sign out a little membership form online, and then when you go to SeaWorld, you take a proof of your child's age, so a birth certificate or passport, something like that, and also proof of your residency, and they give your child a free membership for an entire year. So then the adults usually have to have a membership for themselves, obviously, but
your preschool
totally
kids aren't going by themselves, probably.
Yeah. Wait, you don't do that?
Well, I drop them off
sometimes.
I just
drop my kids off.
But they always come back.
Here's another deal. Tell me about another deal.
Another great deal. Since San Diego has such a huge military population, they give a lot of military discounts. You know, they'll do it at restaurants, they'll do it at the movie theaters, but they also have like these commissaries at the military bases where you can get super discounted tickets on like the amusement parks.
They have like a ticket office there on base.
This is one place they actually will give you Disneyland discounts that I've ever heard of, is the military discounts. But I believe you have to have the military personnel come with you on the trip.
It all circles back
it
to
does.
Disney for
it
you.
It does, I know. Disney
you
and Legoland for some reason.
You,
just give me free tickets.
Yeah. Last on the list, and I don't know that this is technically a hack, but I just think this is something that's useful to spread the word about, is just all of the farmers markets that we have that run here in San Diego County, all up and down the coast and inland. Almost every little town neighborhood has their own farmers market, usually
all
the
beach
on the weekends.
Towns too, for sure, like Del Mar,
Encinitas, Solana Beach, Poway, Rancho Penasquito.
Yeah,
no, it's a great way to just meet other members of the community and, you know, see what's going on. And so it's not technically a hack, but I just think that's a nice little piece of San Diego advice.
Yeah, for sure. Okay, so that is our San Diego hacks living here in San Diego. And if this is your first time to our channel, please subscribe to our channel. Click like below, and as we post new videos every week. Thank you guys for watching.
Bye.
Bye.
We did it, third time's the charm.